Hi everyone, it's Wendy here, and this is the first in a little series of videos that I've called Grammar is Grand. So I'm hoping that you're having a look at this before you delve into the section of the study guide in Module 1 that's to do with sentences and sentence structure. This first video is just a little bit of revision on basic parts of speech for those of you who might not remember this from school, or it might have been a little while since you've looked at it and you just might be a bit rusty on a few things. So here we go. So we can see there that there's five basic parts of speech: the noun, the pronoun, the verb, the adjective, and the adverb. So we're just going to have a little look at each one of them with some examples to see what they do in the sentence. So nouns and pronouns first. So the other way, and probably the way that most of you were taught about these, was that they're naming words, and as you'll see in your study guide when you read this section, sometimes they're also called participants in the sentence, but naming words is just fine if that makes more sense to you. So I've given some examples there of nouns: pencil, computer, Wendy, bicycle, and you'll see in the study guide that there's different types of nouns as well, so read that section carefully. So they're nouns. Pronouns, on the other hand, are words that stand instead of nouns. So I've given some examples there: I, my, her, he, they, and their. So they're fully explained on pages 39 and 40 of your study guide. So have a very careful read of that and make sure you understand the difference between a noun and a pronoun. Verbs, otherwise known as doing words, sometimes, as you'll again see in the book, they are also called processes, so they're things that happen. Some examples here: drive, walk, run, write. They're things we can do or things that can be done. And there's quite a long section explaining verbs and how they work on pages 34 to 38 of your study guide. So go through that carefully and try the activities that are there as you do so. Adjectives, otherwise known as describing words, sometimes again called attributes in fancy grammar land. So very simply, they add value to nouns. They give us some more information about them. So here I've highlighted the adjectives. So red describes something about the car, green describes something about the shoes, and long describes something about the walk. So they're all adjectives. And finally, adverbs, sometimes called circumstances, they tell us something more about verbs. So they tell us how, when, why, and where something might have happened or was done. Sometimes they can be more than one word. In that case, we call them an adverbial phrase or clause. So if you have a look at the examples here, slowly is the adverb in this sentence because it tells us how we walked or how I walked. Yesterday is the adverb. It tells when lunch was eaten. In the shed is an adverbial phrase that tells where the person worked, and because he was hungry is an adverbial clause that tells why the person ate. So, what comes after that? There's three different types of sentences that use these basic parts of speech: the simple sentence, the compound sentence, and the complex sentence. So if you work through your study guide and then watch the next video that follows this one, you'll learn more about the simple sentence. And if you complete the activities along the way and check them with the answers, you'll have a much better idea about the simple sentence. In week two, we'll look at the compound and the complex sentence, so we'll save that up for then.